Salutations, friends. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to talk to you guys about 10 amazing, sophisticated, and mature scents. These are timeless fragrances. Some of these are very iconic. Some of these are newer fragrances. Some of these are older fragrances. But instead of drumming up these youthful, amazingly light, flirty, playful scents, I want to talk about something mature, elegant, and sophisticated today. And those three words are never described. I'm never described that way, but I do have fragrances in my collection that could definitely fall under those wonderful words and beautiful adjectives and under that topic of just fantastic perfume. So if you'd like to know what my picks are, then keep watching. Now, recently, when I look at new releases, when fragrances come out, and when I look at trends in fragrance, there's trends in niche and there's trends in designers. Generally, designers are where a lot of people really look for in regards to what's happening in perfume. Generally, designers move more fragrances than niche, but niche, there is a lot of love and appreciation, and a lot of designers are looking to niche too. Because of that, you see kind of like a blend of worlds, but there's still a very strong presence of what is considered a good designer fragrance. Now, the reason why I'm saying that is with designer fragrances, just like beauty and skincare and just the world in general, there's a lot of emphasis placed on youth. And I don't think that there's anything wrong with people loving being young and people embracing their golden age. I think whatever makes you happy, if you like to dress more youthful, if you like to dress more mature, as long as you're doing it and you're making the choices for yourself and you're happy, then go for it. But when it comes down to perfume, there's a lot, and I mean a lot of youthful, beautiful scents, and it's flooding the market, specifically the designer market. And a lot of people come to my channel and ask, what about mature fragrances? Or I like this one, nobody talks about this. And a lot of times they're iconic scents, they're iconic compositions, and they're beautiful fragrances that for the current market, a lot of people find to be too stuffy, too dated, or can be a little bit too heavy or too complex for their nose. And there's nothing wrong with simplicity and minimalism in perfumery. There's some amazing scents out there. But when I look at mature fragrances, they do have layers, they do have depth, they do have complexity to them. So I didn't just choose fragrances that had a lot of depth and complexity. I tried to choose fragrances in my mind, if I were going to send a mature, sophisticated person, man or woman, well-dressed, well-groomed, and you just look at them and they just ooze sensuality, sophistication, and maturity. That's who I'm dressing or scenting when I chose these fragrances. And I have one fragrance to rule them all in regards to the one that I think is my best recommendation in regards to mature scents. So the first one we're going to talk about is an easy one. This one and the first few actually are the ones where you think about it and you're like, oh, and it's actually called Youth Dew from Estee Lauder. This is beautiful. It's rich, it's inviting, it's powdery, it grabs your attention. Now, some people really love this fragrance and some people don't. And when people think about mature, sophisticated scents, this type of composition really comes into play. Beautiful woods, gorgeous florals, and I love how spicy and balsamic it is. For some people, it can tickle your nose in the right way, and for other people, it can tickle your nose in the wrong way. These kind of woody, balsamic, very floral, heavy, dense scents really play to this sophisticated, I don't quite know what you're wearing, but I really like it. Now, Youth Dew is one of those fragrances where if you smell it out of the cap or on a strip, it doesn't have the same magic and beautiful just sensuality that it has on skin. It smells a little bit too soapy, a little bit too powdery, a little bit too spicy when you smell it like this. It has to be worn on skin. And when it's worn on skin and you smell it on skin, it just smells amazing. Along the same exact lines of Youth Dew, we have Clinique Aromatics Elixir. This is so good, so sexy. I love how sensual this fragrance is. Now, this is not for everybody like Youth Do. These specifically first fragrances I'm going to share with you, part of this list, can be more challenging in regards to their composition. If you're into more minimalistic scents, more modern fragrances, you're going to turn your nose at these. There's a sensuality, a maturity, and a sophistication to these fragrances, and an allure. And like Youth Do, this has to be worn on skin. Now, when I first smelled this the first few times, I didn't like it. There was something about it that it kind of hit me wrong. And this was around the time I was really into fresh scents. Like, light blue was it. I was wearing it. I was wearing a lot of other fresh, bright, citrusy, sparkly scents. And those are great, but those are more youthful. And I wanted to start liking more of these classic compositions, more challenging compositions to me in regards to, this isn't a fresh aquatic, this isn't a woody aromatic, this is something that has depths and layers and is spicy. And I started to really love these types of fragrances when I started wearing them on my own skin, when I started smelling myself, and that sounds so crazy, and smelling how these fragrances were developing on my skin is when I really started to love them. And aromatic elixirs just grew to be a very just mature fragrance, but in a way that just smelled so attractive. One that's a little bit lighter, not as challenging as Youth Do and aromatic elixirs, is from Yves Saint Laurent, and it's Opium. Classic, classic fragrance, beautiful fragrance. Again, wear it on your skin. But when I'm talking about iconic fragrances, iconic, mature, sophisticated, gorgeous, awe-inspiring fragrances. The two fragrances that obviously will be part of this list as mature, elegant perfume we have is Chanel No. 5 and Shalimar. Both of these are Eau de Parfum. I love the flankers to Chanel No. 5. I think they're great. But when you're talking about iconic, timeless maturity, sophistication at its finest, elegance and luxury that's accessible, I think you cannot forget the beauty of Chanel No. 5. This has to be on this list. And considered, and rightfully so, one of the most gorgeous fragrances in the world, you have Guerlain Shalimar. Now, if you like something lighter, you have its flankers, obviously. Lovely. Soufflé, Soufflé Intense, Soufflé Lumière, but Shalimar just is perfection in regards to timeless, iconic, and mature. And again, when I'm talking about mature, I'm not talking about dated. I'm talking about, again, this beautiful, elegant, perfectly groomed, impeccable person, man or woman. How would you scent them? What would they smell like if you walked past them? Now we're going to be going towards the ones that aren't so obvious when it comes down to this list. And the first one I have is Creed Fleurs de Bulgari. This is the fragrance for fit for a queen, and fragrance fit for just somebody that wants to grab attention, know how they want to smell. The flowers in this are beautiful and bold and unapologetic. And there's something about that that just oozes confidence. And I love, love this fragrance. Can't wear it too much because it makes people around me sneeze. It's one of those fragrances I have to be very mindful about where I wear, but I love it. If this didn't make people sneeze around me, it would probably be, it would be one of my most worn scents. I really, truly, love the way this smells on my skin. It has such an air of confidence to it. I feel like I might have a chance at being sophisticated or elegant if I wear this fragrance. There is no real chance of that. I know that. I am realistic here. But I can pretend that I have some sort of elegance when I wear this fragrance. It is just magic on the skin. Now, a newer fragrance to my collection, and one that I think is really gorgeous and fits this maturity, I would say more of a unisex, almost borderline on masculine type of well-groomed gentleman, has to be Behold Patchouli from Gallagher Fragrances. Patchouli is one of those notes, when it's done correctly, it's timeless, it's amazing, it's bold, it's attention-grabbing, it's confident. And there's a confidence to maturity, there's a confidence to elegance, there's a confidence to sophistication. It's something that you know it when you smell it. And to my nose, Behold Patchouli is one of those fragrances that has it. And it's, if you're looking for this type of fragrance that's a little bit more masculine, or if you have a lot of these fragrances and you want to try something new, it is an amazing, amazing perfume. Now these next two are more luxury fragrances and are definitely luxury prices, but these are some of my most favorite fragrances in my collection. And first we have Enslaved from Rouge Parfums. I've talked about this before. This is just liquid elegance, liquid sophistication. It is beautiful. It smells like a higher end, more luxurious, more elevated version of all the fragrances I mentioned before. You can agree with me or disagree with me. That's completely fine. But to my nose, it's what it smells like. And it's softer, it's more rounded, it's more smooth. There's more vanilla in this. And there's just something about the way this performs on the skin that is just amazing. But, and my big old but, I would say that if you're going to invest in a luxury niche-priced fragrance for its sophistication, for a classic composition, for something unique and beautiful and elegant, I love Ibitira from Zirjoff. This is gorgeous. This is a rose and iris combo, and it just smells so amazing. There's a bright aldehydic opening to this, that beautiful sparkle that you get in a lot of these fragrances, but it's brighter and more sparkly and fresher, and that pours itself into this beautiful, just luscious iris and big rose, and it just comes together to be something quite beautiful and light, but still very mature and very elegant. That is not the best one. If I had to choose from my entire collection, and I'm choosing these fragrances from my collection, what fragrance, if I closed my eyes and that person, man or woman, was walking in front of me and they were dressed to the nines, perfectly groomed, elegant, sophisticated, mature, like something out of a Bond film, what would they smell like? And in my mind, that would be from Frédéric Malle, Le Parfum de Thérèse. This is just firstly unique and beautiful. It's luscious, it's bold, it's big, it's got those beautiful woody elements, these gorgeous florals, sparkly opening, all the little bits and bobs that you look for in classic types of compositions that just scream femininity, scream woman, scream man, scream gentleman, scream luxury, money, refinement, sophistication, elegance, confidence, attractiveness, with melon. And it's that melon, it's that beautiful melon note in here that makes it special, that makes it unique, that makes it different. And I feel like if this weren't for the melon, this would still be in this list, but Ibitira would be number one because I just really love that fragrance. It's just fantastic to me. But this melon is so juicy and so perfect, so perfect. And you think a melon makes a sophisticated. See, this is why I can never be any of these things I'm describing. Confident? No way. But I can wear it, I can smell like it, I can pretend. But this melon is it's slightly playful. It's like a smirk. It's like a, hey, yeah, like a little shrug that you give, you know, a confident little smile at this, you know, aside. Like, yeah, I know I'm mature, I got this. But it's different. All of these other fragrances, aside from maybe one or two, they're distinct. You could close your eyes, you could smell them, and you could know, yeah, this smells like this, or yeah, this smells like that. But there's something about the melon that just makes it like a 13 out of 10, just takes it up 2 to 3 notches. And that's why I think it's so perfect, because not only is it mature, not only is it sophisticated, and I know I've been overusing those words, I'm so dang sorry, I need to be more articulate. It's attractive, it's confident, it's refined, but it's playful, and that's what I like. It's not uptight, because just because something is mature doesn't need to be uptight. Just something is mature doesn't need to be stuffy. That melon takes it from being another beautiful, timeless, iconic, classic composition and makes it this scent. And that's why I think it's just one of the most perfect fragrances, and a beautiful mature scent. If you're looking for something sophisticated, if you're looking for something to help with confidence, if smell gives you confidence, if having a perfume that makes you feel a specific way is something that boosts your confidence, this is going to be a great fragrance for you if you like these types of perfumes and these types of compositions. And it's just, I love it. I could sing it praises all day. It's the melon. It really, and it's weird for me to sit here and talk about these like beautiful woody balsamic fragrances, these gorgeous lush white florals, this beautiful rose, this perfect iris. Let's talk about all these fragrances. And then I'm ending on a melon. But truly, honestly, like this is my number one mature scent. Almost a must have, a must smell. Let's just put it that way. A must smell fragrance. If you have the opportunity to get your nose on this scent, please do. Especially if you love these more mature and timeless perfumes. I think you'd at least get a little tickle out of this, but there's just something so sexy and confident and timeless and beautiful about it. I just had to have it be number one as part of this list. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and please let me know below. Obviously, I chose these fragrances from my collection. You might say that some are missing. What are your favorite mature, timeless, and classically sophisticated fragrances? Let me know in the comment section below. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.